Radio Frontier.
This is Football Daft with Stephen Purden.
Midfield dynamo and average actor.
Chris Toll.
Target man, suspicious character.
And
hey, that's happened to Stevenson.
Merry Christmas, troops, and welcome to a special edition of Football Daft, the daftest Scottish football podcast around. And as it's the football Christmas Daft party, John is the only one wearing a Christmas jumper.
I feel bad, man.
No one get the memo?
We did, but do you know what, mate? It's too warm in this room.
Aye, but to be fair, John, you give us the memo the day.
Aye.
No, I mean, you can't just expect me to drop something and go out and buy a Christmas jumper, bro?
Aye.
Some tinsel or something.
And me and Greg are doing, like, a Christmas pantomime. Aye, mate. We're fucking Christmas getting boxes, man.
We have Santa Claus is coming out of town out of our fucking noggin, aren't we?
Santa Claus is coming out of town?
But whatever you say.
Santa Claus is coming out of the closet, man.
Talking about Santa.
Aye, but anyway. Obviously, I'm Stephen Purden, and let's name the other two wise men. Right, first, a man who brings the gift of Frank McAvenny incense.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Well, I was all right. Do you think I was all right? It's Chris Toll. No?
Frank McAvenny. Oh, mate, so John, have you made all these up to be like the three wise men and that?
Aye.
Frankincense and mud and all that shit.
And now who brings the gift of Connor Goldson? It's Grado. So with frankincense and with gold.
John, there's a reason why you're doing Football Daft and no fucking off the ball on a Saturday, mate. Just kind of leave on.
Oh, come on.
Right, no, take that back. Look, it's only have a joke. And by the way, no, I'll tell you what. I'll fucking defend John to the hill here because it shouldn't be the two wise men. I feel John is a part of this podcast now, and I believe
we're the three wise men. He's a donkey in the corner.
There's no more room to the inn.
But what I want to really get to, right, it's got a Christmas feel about it. This weekend, I'm going to sit with the wains. I'm going to watch Home Alone. Grado, what was Buzzfeed Home Alone like?
Wow. So you just know that
I've... Explain to the listeners here, Grado, what's happened.
Mate, well, here's the deal, man. I actually did get to interview Buzz for Home Alone on the radio.
What's his name?
Devin Rattray. Don't try to be smart, mate.
No, I wasn't, mate. I genuinely didn't know.
No,
his name,
you
are.
You're trying to catch me out. What's his name?
Well, he's on the defensive straight away. That's going to be one of these days, isn't it?
Listen, I'm actually all right. Considering fucking, it's not been a good week football wise. I've done all right with old speaking to celebrities and all that. You know what I mean? Interviewed a band this morning and all that. So I did. Felt
who
brilliant.
Did you interview this morning, mate?
A band called The Heights.
The Heights. I've not seen them. Come on, that's a great joke.
What did you say?
I says I've not seen them. Get it? Come on. Yes, we're off to a flyer, boys.
Hey. Right, Grado, tell us about Buzz, man. Buzz feel Home Alone, fuck's sake, come on.
Well, I just kind of tried to get a hold of him, and basically what happened was I managed to get a celebrity reporter in New York to try and track him down. That never worked. Somebody on Twitter says, here, I was the photographer at Buzzy's brother's wedding in the Isle of Skye. I was like, you're joking, man. So I go on the radio and I'm like, what happened? He says, oh, he just looked like Buzz. I didn't want to ask him about Home Alone because I thought he'd get it all the time about his brother and stuff like that. And I was like, and what was Buzz like? And he was like, he wasn't fucking there. I was like, what's that about then? But then we managed to get a hold of his manager and he came on, man, and he was brilliant. Do you know what? He's been a Scotland before. He's one of the Yanks that, of course, I'm Scottish. My grandmother is Scottish, kind of that shit. You know that way they all think they're Scottish.
They've all got a granddad that was born in Brighton or something.
I remember I'd been in Florida wrestling and something. You Scottish? My grandmother's from Leicester, kind of that kind of shit.
Mate, I've got a story for you, right? My mate's walking down Times Square in New York and he's just talking away. And this big guy stops and he goes, hey, excuse me, where are you guys from? The guy goes, my mate goes, we're from Coatbridge. No, he's like, we're from Scotland. He goes, yeah, I know Scotland, but which part of Scotland? He goes, Coatbridge. The guy goes, no shit, I was born in Baleshill.
Yeah, that's a belter. Do you know what I done in 2010 in New York, right? I don't know if I've told this story before on a podcast, right? But I thought this was fucking genius for me, right? I'm not very at the best ideas and all that, right? But see, when I was in New York, we went to the baseball game, right? And I seen these crowd of boys, obviously a bunch of boys from Scotland on a jolly, right? Fucking all the baseball and all that, right? And I went up to them and I went, "Hey, you guys from Scotland?" And they're like, "Yes, yes." I was like, "Hey, man, I tell you what, I think I got the best Scottish accent ever. Can I give it a bash to you guys?" And they're like, "Yeah, no problem." I went, "Here you fucking fanny, you fucking pair of dates, you fucking tubes, who do you think?" They're like, that's fucking brilliant, man, that's brilliant. One guy in the back was like, you're Scottish. And I was like, how you doing, mate? That night I was like, how fucking good was that?
Then they knocked fuck out you for calling
me. Is that a nice good wee story, isn't it?
That's fucking brilliant, that is great, man.
I shouldn't have came on bad day.
Anyway, Buzz was cool and he likes a bridey.
Anyway, right, troops, let's get to Scottish football this week. Since we last spoke, what's been happening? Celtic have managed to put two wins together.
No, 100% since the last time I spoke to these lads. What the fuck's going on?
While Rangers are out in the League Cup.
it happens to the besties.
Aye. I'm not going to lie, right? I was fucking absolutely beeling last night. Beeling, and I'm still beeling, right? I don't know, I'm really angry at Steven Gerrard. I'm really angry at him.
Oh, get a grip, man. It's one game.
No, see that. This is what me and Grado were arguing about last night. See, MD turns around and goes at me. It's just one game.
Right, I tell you what then, with Gerrard,
Let me finish. I would rather it was in the league. Do you know why? Because we've got a big enough cushion in the league right now. But see that game last night? It's not just one game. See that? That's another trophy. It's just went by. Your name's known. Again. Mm-hmm. Gerrard needs to win a trophy. Right. See that game last night? He totally fucking destroyed the left-hand side of our team. See Calvin Bassey. See, let me finish. See Calvin Bassey playing left back, right? See the way we play? We either Jack and Kamara or Jack and Davis. See they two? They always cover both fullbacks, right? Kamara always covers Tav, which is doing good and well last night. But see on the left, he played Joe Aribo. Right, Joe Aribo's not got a defensive mind in his body at all, right? And then you've got Calvin Bassey getting torn to shreds and he's getting no protection in front of him. There was no need to do that last night in a game that we had to fucking win.
I think that's a matter of hindsight. Where I know.
I think it's a matter of a manager.
No, you're right. He's a manager. He is a manager.
He saved himself after it.
He's not going to fucking fling the players under the bus, isn't he? Because if that happens, you came at it's like with them mentality. We always get the jitters running about this time of year. And I think, what are you laughing at, John?
I'm laughing at Chris Tolson.
He's loving it. It's cool.
Do you know what? There was no protest after it, right enough. So it's all right. You know what I mean? It's not like there was no protest. There was no sharks.
No sharks, aye. But I think it's a matter of now. Obviously, we want to win a cup. And to people that say, but it's only the League Cup, that's a lot of shite, because you can say that once we've won the League Cup a few times again, or won any sort of silverware we had an amazing chance there, an absolutely shit hot chance to get that monkey off our back, and it's just a pure frustrating, disappointing.
What do you think, Toll? How's things at Celtic?
You feel when you've seen the result? Were you jumping about, or were you like,
mate, do you know what? See, the last time I seen the score before full time, it was 2-1 to St Mirren. And I just thought to myself, see the way that you do in the group chat, Grado, I was like, Rangers will win. And I didn't even check it again. And then in my group chat, one of the boys had put up the video of Chris Boyd. I was like, what the fuck's going on? I didn't even know the score, and that's the truth. And I went on and checked, and that's when I found out the score.
Quite a lot here, John.
As a non-Old Firm supporter, I like seeing, you know, teams like St Mirren, teams like, you know, Falkirk and stuff going on, and, you know, it's great because it's going to be a trophy for St Johnstone, Livingston, Hibs, or, you know, St Mirren, that they're going to get their name on a trophy, and I think it's good for teams out with the Old Firm to pick up silverware. You know?
St Mirren team covered every fucking blade of grass last night.
See the boy, is it Connolly, man? What a player he is.
I mean,
Whopper, yes.
And I think I even listened to Jim Goodwin in his pre-match interview.
Mate, see when you said that in the group chat, man. I get it. I seen it in his eyes, man.
He was interviewed before the game.
There was a pure air of confidence about him, man. There was.
They deserved it, man. They deserved that win.
They did. What about Celtic, though? All good. Celtic are back, all happy.
That's it. Champions again, mate. That's it.
Right.
That's a monkey.
Moving on. Right. Trips. The biggest news of the week is that Football Daft, he's ready for this?
Yes.
Is the number one football podcast.
Seriously?
In the Cayman Islands.
Where the fuck's the Cayman Islands? Is that Spain?
That's where I keep all my money. So,
it's Crystal's tax haven, right? But it's apparently we're massive in the Cayman Islands. And according to Carlos from Podstatus, not only are we the number one soccer podcast, we are also the number two overall sportscast, plus number 16 in the Czech Republic, number 15 in the United Arab Emirates, and number 11 in Canada.
Hey, Bob.
Where are we in Scotland?
No comment.
It doesn't matter. Chris, why are you trying to fucking break this party up?
We're number one in the Cayman Islands.
We all need to get a Cayman Islands jersey if they get a football
team. We're number one in the Cayman Islands, right?
All right.
When Football Daft, when the pandemic calms down a bit and we get to go out on the road, we will go to the Cayman Islands at some point.
All expenses paid.
A jolly boys.
We need to get somebody for the Cayman Islands to come in my football phone in. Carry on.
Yeah, this is a massive shout out to everyone in the Cayman Islands and maybe even everyone in Czech Republic, and because I went to a pretty good stag do in Prague and the United Arab Emirates and in Canada. All yous out there, all over the world, if you want to get in touch, please get in touch, because we do, myself, Graham and Christopher and John, love everyone of these. Okay? So even though it is the Christmas party, we still have the open line that's still on, as we invite you onto the show to speak to Stephen Keevens, myself, Graham Greedy, and Chris Hunt.
We need to call it the Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Line.
That is beautiful.
Nuts roasting on an open line.
There he goes again, man. I'm telling
you. I'm trying to get myself
on to
celebrity.
Grado, see if he come and done panel, me, you'd be fucked. Right, Trips, this week there is no big question, but like any other workplace, we have an award ceremony as we bring you the Football Dafties 2020. Scottish BAFTAs have nothing on this, by the way. And we'll find out who you've voted for as best guest, best story, best banter, and the big one, Employee of the Year. And it's no party without a plus one, so we're all bringing a guest on later on. And as well as that, it's Christmas, we're in the spirit of giving. So later on, Falkirk manager David McCracken will join us to see if he can get off the bottom of the leaderboard on the quiz. I really look forward to that, man. Cracks needs to get off the bottom.
Football Daft with G4 Claims. Been involved in a road traffic accident? Call them now on 01698 767 172.
The other day, I was watching the telly, and it was saying that they're going to put Santa's Journey onto a Sky channel. I was watching it, and they said a few years ago his sleigh stopped a quarter of the way along, and they couldn't fucking figure out who it was. It turns out that his fucking sleigh had crashed, and I thought to myself, do you know who Santa should phone?
I think he should have phoned G4 Claims.
Tell me about him, Stevie.
If Santa was to have a road traffic accident, his sleigh was to crash, he should phone G4 Claims. And remember, if you've been in a road traffic accident or you're not at fault, G4 Claims can make it easy for you. They can provide you with the complete accident management support you require. They'll recover the cost from the at-fault party, sort out a like-for-like vehicle replacement. They will also organise your vehicle to be repaired at one of their approved body shops and return to you. Should your vehicle be deemed a write-off, they will recover the pre-accident value for your car and write you a big, fat check for it. And best of all, it won't cost you a penny as they charge the at-fault insurance direct. G4 claims don't cold call, they don't buy data, and once they have processed your claim, your insurance will remain unscathed. And the best thing is, Nicole and the team over there won't take on your case if they don't think they can help. So if you're like Santa, maybe his Santa has been in an accident, you don't know. If you have been in a road traffic accident, know someone that has, get on to G4 Claims on 01698-767-172. That's 01698-767-172. Get them at notatfaultclaim.com or find them on social media at G4 Claims Limited. G4 Claims.
Not at fault claims. Maybe they.
Ho, ho, holy crap, it's time for another football daft opening. Try to get Christmas into every little feature today.
There you go.
So it's basically, it's loosely based on a football phone.
Hey, remember, it's chestnuts roasting on an open line.
Oh, so it is.
I tell you, come on.
Celtic, yeah, I should have thought of that. Aye. Maybe you're a Celtic supporter, you're feeling confident again and want to come in and rub it into Gradle and Stephen. Maybe you're a worried Morton supporter, news this week that Morton could be going bust. Or perhaps you just want to talk about your favourite Christmas movie. That's what we're here for. So let's go to our first call straight away as we hand over to our panel of Stephen Keevans, Graham Guidi and Chris Delhunt. And our first call on today is Jimmy.
Hey, we are. We're in there.
Hey, how you doing, Jimmy?
How are you doing, my man?
Not bad, not bad at all.
Jimmy, yeah, you're through to the panel. What would you like to say?
Well, we had a couple of questions. One is about the draw last night for the League Cup semi-final. I thought it was actually quite an interesting draw. And the second one is, do you think we should bring back pipe bands to cup finals?
Jimmy, I'm going to start right by saying I have stayed away from social media and most televised things about football as soon as the final whistle went, so I don't even know what the fucking draw is.
I'm surprised you're actually on the day.
Jimmy.
As soon as the final whistle went, I turned the telly off and took the dog out of walk, and I've not looked at much social media. I don't even know who got through against who.
Bob, do you know what? I deleted Facebook last night. I thought I'm keeping off it for a couple of days, but I had to put it back on to fucking day for the radio this morning that lasted fucking 7 hours, but that's what I done.
So who did Tibbs get?
We got St Johnston.
Right.
But the interesting fact is, there's an interesting fact here is that the last two cups that we won, we beat St Johnston in the semi-final.
Oh,
really?
Yeah,
high
B, Jimmy.
I'm a high B,
aye. Right, so you've got Hibs, of course, St Johnson, and who's the other one there? St Mirren,
Livingston.
I would say Hibs are the favourites there.
If you're going for hoodoos, Jimmy, you're wanting to stay away from Livingston.
Absolutely. I was there in 2004. Still hot.
That was a hard one to watch. But I think the Hibs name's on that cup.
Aye, St Johnson won't be an easy game, but it'll be a hard game.
Absolutely not. But we're famous for Hibs, isn't it?
Aye, that's true.
We're nearly fucking doing that, mate. We're nearly taking the other mantle of Hibs, isn't it? Know what I mean? We're getting quite good at that and get a chance to win a trophy. We Hibs, it, know what I mean?
So. Listen, see when you get turned over half a team that then get turned over half Livingston, you can't slag MD. Do you know what I mean? So I'm just keeping quiet on this one.
You need to fill me in, Jimmy, about pipe bands at cup finals. What's the history with that?
Well, it's been traditional in Scottish Cup finals and Cup finals that the pipe bands played, and then they went for all the razzmatazz and the flares and the fireworks.
I think you can have both.
By the way, what I will say is you can actually get bagpipes that fire shoots out of. So why don't they just kill two birds with one stone and get the fire shooting bagpipes? Aye. Do you know what I mean? There you go. Surely that'll cut down the cost.
I think what Jimmy says right, but I think with the whole razzmatazz they have at cup finals now, I think they could have both. Why not have a wee bit of Scottish tradition and amongst the whole fucking razzmatazz?
He's got a point, because you know what? I've been to cup finals where I think it's been ruined by them trying to make it fancy, by putting on music that they need.
Do you know what? You blame the fucking Super Bowl for that shit.
You're right, Jimmy, man.
You've got a point there, right? But the Super Bowl date, right? They get
that's
big
right.
names in. Scotland, think they're getting big names in, and they get some fucking band or some singer.
They're going for the Bank of Scotland advert.
Aye. But just for the record, when the cup finals happen, if it's a if it's a no bad bit of dough, if they want me to go and do something, I'll do it. You know what I mean? So I'm not really, I'm not saying no.
Well, Stevie, if they listen to this show, they'll know I've got a voice on me. So Amy McDonald might be out the fucking door.
You might be getting there. With a full fucking pipe band behind you, you're going,
ho, do that again. Do that again, Toe, that was brilliant. Do that again, go, ho,
ho, ho, re, ho, ho, re, ho, ho, re, ho, re, ho, re, ho, re,
Jimmy, I hope all the questions have been answered. Thank you for coming on Football Daft, sir.
You're absolutely welcome.
Jimmy, thanks for listening. Have a good Christmas in the year, my man.
Cheers, guys.
Have a good Christmas, Jimmy. Next up on the open line, it is Dale Smart.
Dale Smart.
Hello.
How's it going, mate?
No bad, yeah.
There we go.
Good, mate, what have we got here? Is that a cowed and beef, man?
It is.
The Blue Brazil.
Oh, my man. Finally. There we go.
Not an Old Firm fan. An actual football fan, mate. I like that. It's good.
Massive cowed and beef fan. I work for the club as well.
What do you do?
You're a goalie.
I'm part of their media team.
Oh, so you deal with the Twitter on that?
I don't personally deal with Twitter, but I record the videos and put a GoPro behind the walls and stuff.
Is that your full-time job?
No, I'm a manager in a supermarket.
You've got a story to tell for the boys, haven't you?
Aye, so probably four weeks ago, I was at my work and my partner used to have cancer a couple of years ago. She's fine now. She phoned me up and says, right, I've just had my blood test taken. The doctors think I might be pregnant. So,
brilliant.
So I'm like, never even held a bairn before. Fucking shit scared the bairns. So right. We'll book an appointment with the doctors the next day just to see, check out and that. So I picked her up for her work at 11 o'clock that night, got home to my house, and she come through to my room and she was like, there's water coming at me. And I was like, no, you've just pissed yourself. You just pissed yourself. And then she's like, no, there's something wrong here. So obviously I took her to the hospital and that, and within a couple of hours, there was a baby.
What?
Brilliant.
So how long before this happened did you find out?
I found out at half five that night, and our water broke at 12 o'clock in the morning.
Fucking hell, man.
My God, man. That's so...
You woke up that morning not knowing that your missus was pregnant and you went to bed that night a da?
Pretty much, aye. So,
holy shit.
The bairn's really healthy.
That's amazing, mate.
I've got a wee boy now. I'm under the moon.
Mate,
do you know something? This is a Christmas special we Football Daft this week.
Mate.
And that is such an uplifting story, man. That's brilliant.
That's like the actual story of Christmas. Updated for modern times.
Considering the year it's been as well, I think it's...
So what did you call him?
Lucas. I'm not trying to make Bob's Heed big here, but I'm a massive River City fan and I wanted to call him Lenny. But she went,
aye. Well, do you know what, mate?
That's a beautiful story, that Neil.
You know that? Mate. So he's Lucas Smart.
Yeah.
Nobody will ever Lucas Smart as your son.
Exactly, mate. Exactly.
What a name, man.
That's a beautiful story, class. Mate.
That is amazing, mate. Honestly, that is like, you couldn't have a better Christmas story than that, man. That's brilliant.
I think, obviously, we never had anything. Stuff like that, and all the families.
Aye, obviously, like Johnny. You never had Johnny's either, my man. Eh?
We got a baby box for the Scottish Government and there's Johnny's in there, so I'll be putting us up
in it. That's an amazing story, so thank you so much for coming on and sharing it on Football Daft, and have yourself a great Christmas as a family.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
All the best, mate.
Perfect, cheers. Brilliant, man. Brilliant.
Cheers, guys.
Thanks, Dale.
Take care, Merry Christmas.
Good luck to the Blue Brazil.
Thanks, cheers.
And it's the final call of the year on the open line, and we couldn't end the year without this guy. He's Earl Laurie from Denniston. It's Davey with another story, and he's got a Christmas story for us this week, gentlemen.
I love this guy, man. There he is.
Hello,
man. What's happening, troops?
How are you, mate?
I'm doing well, mate, but I must admit, last night was sore. We can't hide this. Listen, see, before we take, I don't know if this will go on the outtakes or whatever, but you know that way when you debrief with your pals and you talk to your pals about the football? Well, last night, me and my best pal were arguing about the game, and obviously I had a few bevvies, and I waited to the early hours in the morning before
that
I...
sounds like a story I've heard already, by the way. Yeah.
Right? So you send them a voice note, do you know what I mean? Eventually, when you've got the balls to date. So I don't know how this, if you'll be able to hear it or whatever, but I'll try.
Andrew's car. I love you. Listen, mate, I'm still depressed about last night. I really am. The thing is, right, you can only wait until the games come now and take each game as it is, right? Which is a bit of a cliche in itself. However, I do have the fear a wee bit. That's not a bomb, by the way, that's my wife.
That was fucking brilliant. I know that's a cliche in itself.
Brilliant. Davey, you've got a Christmas story for us, I believe.
By the way, just for the record, because I ken there's a wee ginger guy that is a patron on your podcast that believes my stories are all made up. They're actually all true, believe it or not. You know what I mean? So I just want to clarify this before I tell it.
Go on, mate.
So, we're a boys' night out. It's like a 5-year reunion after uni, and it's obviously in the lead up to Christmas. So we start off in Driftwood at the bottom end of Sockey Hall Street.
Sockey Hall Street, aye.
And we're playing pub golf. So the way we play pub golf is we go to the pub and we decide if it's a par 3, 4, or 5. And that defines how many rounds you have in that pub before moving on to the next one.
Right.
Right?
Good shout.
So,
Jesus Christ, you must be obliterated.
Aye, well, this is the point, Paul. So this started at 2 o'clock in the afternoon on a Saturday, and as you can imagine, in the lead up to Christmas, you're out on a Saturday. Every cunt's out in the lead up to Christmas for December onwards. So we get to, I think the last pub that we were in before we took a right turn was Lauders, and you ken Lauders is a wee bit.
Next to me and Grado's fucking.
It's rough,
Pavilion
right?
Theatre.
So we take a right turn at this point, and then the next pub we hit, I can't even mind the name of it, but it was Black and White by Design, and it was an old man's pub. And as you walk in,
is that the Raven? Is it not?
Every cunt had teeth like Jim Leighton, and that was just the birds. Do you know what I mean? So it was a rough.
The Raven's
pub.
A bit more trendy, is it?
It was rough. But this night, this particular night, they had a Britain's Got Talent sort of theme going on in the pub. And our end game was we were going down to the Horseshoe because we wanted to finish the night with karaoke because there was a few boys in our company that were chanters. So sure enough, as it is, the chanters are up. The Britain's Got Talent night, they're getting it. They're big numbers on karaoke. There was a boy in our company that wanted to tell a few jokes and he went up to tell jokes. Davey, you need to do something. I was like, well, I've got fuck all in my locker. So obviously, I had one impression in my locker at this time, which was the X Factor voiceover guy.
I remember that. Yeah. Rachel added AG.
Aye, well, that's it, Grado. So I went like, Simon Carr, Rachel added AG.
Good.
You know what I mean? Like that, right? So, and then the one that ended of it was I went, I'm your host, Dermot. Oh. Leary, right? So I ended up winning the competition. It was 25 quid. So that was fucked in the kitty. And we were all just, hang me. But this bird comes up to me, right? And she goes like, oh, you're dead talented, you, right? When I was at the bar getting the rundown. And I'm like, I already know the minute she said that to me, everybody's got an ego. I was going home with her. Didn't ken what...
Aye.
I didn't give a fuck what she looked like. I was going home with her. But the boy, my mate, Big Roscoe, is doing like that behind me. He's like, but I was like, fuck it. So I done the thing that you should never do. I ditched the boys on the night out, and I just fucking went anywhere in a taxi. I know, put my horns up right away. So I was like, where'd you stay? And she goes, oh, I stayed in the West End, right? So let's just say that was very vague in context. So we're gone in the black hack, the last thing I remember seeing was Annie's Land train station, right? And there was this big tower block. Sure enough, it was fucking grey and blue. And as we go in, would you know, she stays right at the fucking tap. So we're in this lift and I'm going, no. Mm-hmm. So we get to the tap, we go close and she opens the door. Now, I want you to picture this because we've all had hangover food on a night out, right? Picture an onion badgie being de-panted by a bit of pecora. The bit of pecora fucking the onion badgie. This was the smell of the aroma that greeted you when you walked in this fucking hangway, right? It was rank rotten. And then, as you went through the apartment, there was 8 cats running about. The sofa had claw marks on it, wee bits of fluff poking out of the tap. I'm going, oh no. But at this point, I wasn't sober enough to sort of comprehend all of this. So I'm sitting down and she's like, do you mind if I put a scary movie on? I'm like, I ain't bother, on you go. So she puts on this fucking film. And all I remember is seeing bits of it, but there was like possessed nuns and priests in it. And we'll get back to this in a minute. But halfway through the film, she goes like that to me. She says, you want to get us a bag of crisps? I was like, aye, all right. Like, she's like, beef space raiders. So I was like, walk through. And I walks into this kitchen. And there's a fucking pot of that Ben and Jenny's ice cream. Fucking, it's been lying there for weeks. It's empty. There's the Cadbury Swiss rolls. There's one left in it. You can tell there's been weeks. And then the multi-pack of beef space raiders are lying on the flare, crumpled into like the melonium, whatever the flaring was, the vinyl, whatever the fucking was. And I was going, oh no. So I shouts, I think you've no Chris left. And she comes running through and she goes like, that's my fucking brother. What a fucking bastard. And I'm going, fuck. So obviously at this point, I'm too pish to comprehend everything that's going on. So I let it fly in my head. She comes back, she goes, won't spin me. So we're sitting on the couch, right? So we're sitting on the couch and I'm spooning into her, right? And then at the point in this film, there's a wee boy who commits suicide. And she goes like that, that's how my fucking brother died. And I'm going like that, oh, so you got a couple of brothers, like? And she went like that, no. She says, the brother I was telling you about earlier, I'm a clairvoyant. Well, I'm telling you the new, nae cunt has run down a set of stairs faster than a tower block than fucking me. I would have put Usain Bolt to fucking challenge that night. I swear to fuck. You mind that episode of Friends when they're saying there's a Chandler-shaped hole in the door? There's a fucking baby-shaped hole in her fucking door, I'll tell you that. Honestly.
Man. See, the thing is, I believe that story.
Honestly, and I tell you, see if there's any cunt listening to this podcast that stays in Annie's Land near a tower block, and you know anybody that has 8 cats, avoid them.
Thank you for bringing us Christmas cheer once again.
Brilliant, man.
All the best to have Christmas and that.
All the best, Stevie, mate. Brilliant.
Take care, Davey.
Proud to hear you again, mate. Oh, have a good one, pal.
I'll speak to you soon.
Football Daft with G4 Claims. Find them on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram at G4 Claims Limited.
Welcome to the Christmas edition of the Player Profile Playoff. I say it's Christmas edition, there's nothing Christmassy about it, it's just the usual game, but we'll just call it the Christmas edition. Remember, Scottish football fans eat over 1 million pies a year, and Pie Sports bring you the home of the real taste of the game. Piesports.com, where you can order yourself some Scotch pies, steak and gravy pies, macaroni pies, and you can do that by heading to their website or calling their SOS hotline, which is 0141 739 9999, 01417399999. Thank you, Stephen.
So, John, you're saying that it's a Christmas quiz. Does that mean that more than likely Evander Snow is going to turn up?
Oh, shit, I wish I'd thought of that. That's very good. But he did play in the season we're about to unveil. But remember, for Pi Sports, you can get them delivered in 48 hours. They'll do it free of charge to a bunch of postcodes. Just check that out on their website and they'll get the Pi Steer for the games this weekend. It is the player profile playoff. And on to play today, it's Kenny, who's our Rangers supporter. How you doing, Kenny?
How you doing, Kenny, mate?
Good. I'm good. How are you guys?
Brilliant, mate.
Good, mate. Good to see you, Kenny. Good to see you. Good to see you, mate.
It's good to finally get a Rangers fan on.
So each week, Kenny, we basically pick a different season from Scottish football. We do a player profile. And this week, we're heading back to the 07-08 season. Ooh. What are your memories of that season? That was the season that Rangers won the Cup double.
It did.
Was that
the
League Cup,
the Scottish Cup? McGregor saved the penalty from Scott McDonald, was it? After Van Henry Hessegor or Hesseling died.
He did not die.
Fell.
What are you talking about, Scott? Wait a minute. Scott McDonald get the penalty and McGregor saved it, but Nakamura was put the ball into the top corner and fucking that big Spaniard boy saved it with his right hand.
Carlos Coelho, the Rangers.
Remember, there was no dive involved in that game, Kenny boy.
Do you know what, John? Listen to this, right? You know how I'm good at this, right? Let's be honest.
Yeah, I'm good at this.
And I'd say my strong season's 95, 96, probably 99, 2000, but my other one is 2007, 2008.
Oh, well, yeah.
I was fucking mental that I was, I don't know, I was just... Yeah. I think it's because I had a job in the council and I was on fucking internet all day, every day, FIFA stuff.
Yeah. Well, it was the year that Gretna were in the first season in the top flight and they went bust.
They went relegated, they went down, didn't they, that season?
Aye, and they went bust that season. Yeah. They went Queen of the South, obviously, beat Aberdeen in the semi-finals of the Scottish Cup and gave Rangers a right good game in the Scottish Cup final as well. So that was what happened in that season. But obviously, we're interested in the players that played in that season. So I'm going to pick out a name for you to play here, Kenny. Anyone you want to play?
I'll try and avoid Guido.
Try and avoid
if that's his strong year.
He's very good.
I don't know, just
and me. Luckily, you've avoided Grado. It's Chris that you're going to be playing.
Oh, here we go, motherfucker.
Let's go for it.
Okay, what's your buzzer going to be, Kenny?
It was either going to be something inside so strong in honour of Mr. Lennon, but I'll go with Shark. Our talking point is Scottish football.
Brilliant. And what's your buzzer going to be, Chris?
Chris.
Original.
Wait a minute, I'll go for Jingle Bells.
Right. Right, excellent, you made it Christmassy. That's why we're calling it the Christmas Player Profile Playoff. There you go. Right, okay, boys, first name out of the hat. He's ready.
Right.
This midfielder started his career at Motherwell before a brief spell down south with Plymouth. He then returned to Firpack to make a further 378 appearances for
Crystal.
Yes, Chris.
Jed Brannan.
Wrong.
Oh.
I'll continue you out. In 2015, he was granted a testimonial and still remains at the club.
That's
on the match to this day.
Oh, Keith man, Lasley, we know who that
Keith
is.
Lasley. We know who that
Keith
is.
Keith Lasley, correct.
He was on the show.
Well done.
On the show. Poor research, Chris.
I know, mate. I know.
Such a good-looking man as your mum would always
I love him, Mike Grado sitting.
Handsome bastard.
Jed Brannan.
Right, okay, next player up. It is 1-0 to Kenny. This Dutch goalkeeper arrived on loan at Falkirk from Newcastle at the start of the season and went on to...
Chris. Tim Krul.
Correct, Tim Krul.
Tim Krul. Chris. No.
1-1. Here is the decider, boy.
She's good, man.
Whoever gets this walks away with the pies. In this season, this midfielder played against Bayern Munich as Aberdeen faced them in the UEFA Cup and managed a 2-2 draw at Pittodrie.
Chris. Sonny Aluko.
Midfielder, Chris, you're out.
Pressure.
Kenny, here you go. Pressure on.
It could have been Andy, too.
Yep.
I know, that was a pure early. I was an early buzzer, too.
Starting his career at Rangers, he arrived at Pittodrie via Dunfermline, where he rejoined his former boss, Jimmy Calderwood, for a fee of £250,000.
Oh, I know that.
He moved down south at the end of the season with spells at Preston North End and Fleetwood Town before finishing his career at Kilmarnock. Kenny, who is it?
Come on, Biggin.
Just for the win.
Shot, Chris Burke.
No. Stevie Smith.
You're wrong, Stevie.
Oh.
No. Barry Nicholson.
Correct.
Oh, well done, mate. Well done.
Fine. Right, okay. You're still in the game then, Chris. Here we go. This player was one of a number of players that have played for both Hearts and Hibs. The midfielder arrived at Tynecastle after two seasons at Easter Road.
Chris.
I've got that.
Chris.
Michael Stewart.
No.
I'll continue with the clue.
That's what I was going to say.
No, you're right. He was also a failed trialist at Rangers, correct?
Which are right,
I thought you were going to say, did Tom Hartley not play with Hibs when he was younger as well? I thought maybe before it was him.
Aye. You know what, though? Since it's Christmas, I think we should give Kenny the pies.
You know what, I think as it's Christmas, Kenny, you're more than welcome to the pies, my man.
Thank you very much. You know what?
That's well great, done. Man. Christmas spirit.
I love this bit.
Absolutely. And remember, if you want to get pies for the games this weekend, head to piesports.com.
Football Daft with G4 Claims. Been involved in a road traffic accident? Get them now at notatfaultclaims.com.
Guys, you sorted out presents for your missuses for Christmas yet?
I've almost got everything. There's a couple of bits and bobs.
Yeah. Can I say a good thing would be to get them? So I've talked about it before, getting signed up to Stitch Fix because it's brilliant. I've signed up to it, my wife signed up to it. Basically, it gets your clothes sent to your house. You can have it every month, you can have it every couple of months, however you want to do. But anyway, it would be great, you know, they get all your sizes right because this is what Stitch Fix is all about. Basically, there's no consistent sizes when you go into the shops, is there? And I'm sure we, like you guys, find it hard to get the right size at the right time. Is it a medium? Is it a small?
Certainly,
sir. I know, I'm sure you do, Chris.
Yes.
But wouldn't it be great? Basically, Stitch Fix is great to sort you out with an online personal shopper. It's basically, the whole company is a personal styling company. So to get started to Stitch Fix, if you're looking for a present for your other half, dead easy to do, gaelicstitchfix.co.uk/daft. You set up your profile and they'll deliver great looks personalised just for you or for your wife because it's great. You get to pick all, it's like a wee questionnaire and you get to pick what clothes you like, what colours you like, what type of style you like. They've got designer styles, they've got their own stylist up there and they've got anything to suit any kind of budget. You basically pay a £10 styling fee for each fix, which is credited towards anything you keep. So if you take out, I got a jacket the last time I got it, it was really good. And obviously the £10 comes off the price of the jacket, so it's really, really good. There's no subscription either, which is great. And the shipping, returns and exchanges are really easy. Just take out what you want from the box, put back what you're in, take it down to the post office, everything's done for you. It's really, really easy. And basically, Stitch Fix is a try before you buy it home service. So basically, you try it on. If you don't like it, you send it back. If you keep all five items from the box, you get five items in the box, you get 20% off your order as well. So
nice.
Always good. And we've got a special offer for you if you're looking to get someone signed up for Christmas. Head to stitchfix.co.uk/daft. That's stitchfix.co.uk/daft. You'll be supporting the show. And like I say, get that 20% off for keeping all five items. It's a great service. Get involved.
Football Daft with G4 Claims. Find them on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram at G4 Claims Limited.
So at most work parties, you need to justify them by having some sort of award ceremony. So we thought we'd have our own. So welcome to Football Dafties 2020.
Hey! Gosh, come on, this is where I make my
Football Dafties 2020.
So we have four categories for our award ceremony. Best banner, best story, and the two biggies, best guest and employee of the year. So to present the first award for best story, you might know him for ICW, you perhaps might know him as Tam Spraggins, or maybe he's knocked your jaw clean off. It's Crystal.
Alright, troops, well, the nominations are David Templeton with a story about Chaba Laszlo slagging him off even though he hadn't seen the game, and Romanov stealing his boots.
So his interpreter used to get training kit and come out and hit shots into his interpreter. And if there was no goals, he would just kick the ball and his interpreter'd have to go and get the ball and bring it back to him.
Look, when you're playing at school, when you're the goalie, I was the goalie and it goes by the fucking, you have to go and chase the ball.
Yeah, I swear, it was like a wee puppy dog having to get the ball from. But I used to, like, we'd be training and then a couple of the boys would be like, by the way, he's got your boots on. We used to just go in the boots and my boots on as well because they're the same size as us.
That was a belter, that one. But is it better than Jim Leishman getting chucked off of the team in the park stage?
Gordon has got us backstage for the gig. And you know the main stage, right?
Aye.
At the side, there are the huge amplifiers. You know, you can... So I'm standing behind the amplifier and I'm phoning my mates. Hey, whoa. Aye, you're up there. He says, watch the telly. So I goes out to the mic. This thing,
you do that.
You're going to get me woof. I'm going
to chuck it. The next one that we've got here is Owen Coyle after making a cup of gravy instead of coffee for Jeff Brown.
That was brilliant.
That was a topper.
That was a topper.
Owen Coyle was class, man.
I know.
Is that you finished there? I says, aye, come in. Aye, I won't come in, don't you worry. So she's in the corner. And it's been that much rain, you know, when you've come in, the wet and it's still running down your nose and all that. So it's trickling down. The kids are soaked through. So she says, that better be worth it. I says, Kerry, it couldn't have went any better. I said, the only thing was he threw me at the start. She says, ask for a coffee. Could I find a coffee? I say, I eventually found it anyway. With it. She went, we've not got coffee. I says, aye, we have. She went, that's Bisto gravy, you know.
I think when I tell you the next one, I think that we know what direction this is going in, ladies and gentlemen. The next one is Mark Reynolds for his story about Archie Knox asking if he had spunk or if he was a shite bag.
A football player needs spunk. He's like, that's one of the ingredients. Like, you've either got it or you've not.
What are the ingredients?
You've either got spunk or you're a shite bag. You've either got... Oh. and then he went round the changing room and gave us a noise if we were either a spunk or a shite bag.
No way.
I've never seen a room of grown men wanting a man to go in my face.
That was the best it's got to be, man. It's got to
right.
be.
And without further ado, the winner gaining 65% of the vote is, of course, Mark Reynolds. Spunk or shite bag.
Hey!
Worthy
winner.
That was a cracker. That is a worthy winner.
On to our next award for best banter. You will know him from River City. You'll know him from Pantle. You might even know him as Boy on the Bike in 1999's Rat Catcher, the movie. To present the award, it's none other than Shouse Out Bob, Stephen Podden.
I was also mugger number two in Sweet 16, but it doesn't really matter anyway. But we'll just move on, right? But and the nominations are... Chris Toll for I'll Take the Jaw Clean Off You.
Get out. It's a fucking game on a podcast. You're not losing money, you fucking idiot.
You call me a fucking idiot again. I'll take the jaw clean off you, you fucking
dick. All right.
Oh.
Probably the most thing MD Stokes me about now.
Aye. It is, man.
It went viral.
It went viral.
But is it better than Chris Toll for a story about the time he found out he was meant to be a mask?
I can't even say it.
Chris Toll for his story about the time he found out he was meant to be a mascot at a Celtic game, only for it not to happen.
I didn't know I was going to be the mascot. My dad never told me. It was a surprise, but it got cancelled.
What did he tell you when you were fairy on or something like that?
After the game.
When I sit you down when you're 30, Chris.
I hug my name on that.
Aye, look, this is, honestly, it's been eating away at me for years.
Aye. Get out.
Tell me to say, come back at my door. Tell me, listen, Chris, I've not stopped thinking about this since fucking 1994.
Oh, man. You know the way Paul McStay taking you in for a bag of seats? I tell you one better than that. You're supposed to be the mascot that night, son. Dad! No! No!
Or is it better than Chris Toll for claiming Scott Sinclair is better than Brian Laudrup?
The stats between Scott Sinclair and Brian Laudrup.
Mm-hmm.
and Scott Sinclair's stats for his time in Scottish football
right.
for about the same length of time. Obviously, mm-hmm. it's not the same era.
Mm-hmm.
Loudrop's playing against better. Right. Is Loudrop playing against better players, actually? You say like we're shite back in the day, aren't they?
Right, so on Football Daft this week, well, on Football Daft last week, Chris Toll tried to put Scott Sinclair in his dream team, forgot about Nakamura, and now this week, Chris Toll's trying to tell me that Scott Sinclair's a better fucking player than I Brian Loudrop.
Not. Where
fucking
and hell, finally, Davey, for his story about Alan McLaren's Bobby.
I turned round, and Alan McLaren's Bobby staring right at me, man. Honestly, God. You have no seen a Bobby this size. There's two things you can see from outer space. One, the Great Wall of China, and the other one is Al McLaren's Bobby.
So, Azza, you've got to win one here. One you've got to win it. You know what I mean? Right.
It's just a pleasure and to be nominated, Stephen. Just a pleasure.
Three times. And the winner with 62% of the vote is, of course, I'll take a jaw cleaner off you.
Hey!
Would you like to say a few words, Chris?
Well, you know, as I said, it's been a tough year. We've all come through a lot of tribulations this year. And
right, Grado, go into the big award now, mate.
Right, the next award is...
The next award is
for...
In a Imperial Hospital.
The best guest of the year. The best guest of the year, and the nominations are Owen Coyle.
We went to Queen of the South, and there was a guy called Michael Clarenti, and he said, right, boy, this is what I wanted you to do. Jimmy Boyle was the team, Peter Harrison, Silky, they were playing the right-hand side. Me and Coyle were playing through the middle as the strikers. And he said, right, Jimmy, I want you to play 2-1-2s with Silky, Peter Harrison. Peter, Silky, you play the ball to the byline for Jimmy Boyle. Jimmy, you cross it in. Ali, Coyce, I want you in the penalty spot to go up, do a bicycle kick, and put the ball in the top corner.
Yogi.
So he gets up in the morning, comes down in the kitchen, and a guy's in the fridge. Russell goes, morning. The guy pulls his sheets back out the fridge and goes, morning. Mick Jagger.
Mark Reynolds.
That's a different level, man.
That isn't it? Especially getting used to it. Like, where's my soul? Next to Johnny Hazy's shite, man. Just step out of that.
And the boys would just clean the boots out and sign them and give them to somebody. that never happened. I want to go on record with any legal liabilities. That never happened,
mate. Craig Levine.
So I woke up in the morning, I felt, you know, I'd been sitting in the toilet and I felt terrible, you know. And I'd phoned to let the manager, Alan McDonald, know. And he said, look, just forget it. Little did I know they'd fuck it up, though, eh?
Before we announce the winner, guys, who was your favourite? And do you think MD is unlucky to miss out on a nomination? Well,
I think Barry and Bob are unlucky. I think Barry and Bob are unlucky.
I enjoyed Barry and Bob. I also enjoyed Chuck Young.
Yep.
Chuck Norris.
I was going to say Chuck Ying.
Can I put a big shout out for Kenny Duker? I thought Kenny was brilliant.
Aye, Kenny Duker.
He was great as well. He was really good.
Can he forget some of our Legends Lottery guests and all, though?
Aye. Mate, Rob McLean was brilliant.
Aye.
Do you know who was good? Because you can do that road, a Rob McLean commentary. Derek Ray was good.
Anyway, and the winner, Craig Levine with 36.1% of the vote, narrowly beating Yogi, who had 31.8%.
Done, Craig.
Craig Levine, he was good, wasn't he?
He was brilliant, man.
Now, for the final award of the proceedings, it's Employee of the Year, and to present the award, it's a man behind the show, the man, the big cheese, the award-winning producer John, who did not write this intro at all.
Of course not. Thanks for that, guys. The nominees for Employee of the Year are, of course, Grado.
Hey!
I feel like a YouTuber, look at my chair. Hi guys, welcome to the channel.
$1 million bucks.
Yeah. I've had that in here for years, but I never use it. But I've been watching a lot of YouTube and all that. And the day, you notice I've got the mic out of picture now. I'm swinging about.
Hi guys, it's me, it's Grado here at Football Daft. She spoke fuck.
Stephen Podden.
Hey! No, he's a hard, he likes a scrap, guys.
Is he?
Oh, aye, he's quite tidy, like, he knows how to handle himself. Like, he's not afraid of a bit of violence.
Fuck, he,
had a walk experience.
Grado would try and get funny with him in a night out if he bumped into him. And imagine Grado came in, gave Football Daft and say, what happened? Martin Geisler kicked fuck out of me at the weekend.
Crystal.
I've just been told Rangers are in talks with Tommy Wright. Tommy Wright, ain't he? Manager's fucking Rangers. It's probably a shite, obviously. Me, you get all these fucking messages and stuff like that all the time, but I don't know, is that maybe, are you hearing something about Gerrard that you're not letting on?
There you go, that's a Football Daft exclusive. Tommy Wright is coming to Rangers according to Crystal.
Right, well, I'm going to take two things for this, right? The first thing is, I was only passing all information that I'd been given. Right. And the second thing is, I can't put anything in the group chat anymore.
And me.
Hey!
Thank you. 25 lanes on Zoom, ready to go. He hears from downstairs, Stephen! He's like, what the fuck? Runs upstairs, there's her on this princess party with a, have you ever seen the picture of the massive cock in the shoe?
I can just imagine.
Sitting behind him with Elsa and Anna. He's like, oh!
So,
it was a tight decision. Could have went either way. But the winner, 40% of the vote, Employee of the Year, and the Football Dafties 2020. He's only been here for half the year. It's Grado! Would you like... would you like to make a speech, Grado? Would you like to make a speech?
Aye, so anyway, moving swiftly on.
I just want to thank everybody for the great... it's obviously been a hard year for everybody with the virus and all that and other things that have kind of went wrong and stuff like that. But I must say, you know, I come on this podcast every week and I'm crabby as fuck. I think it is just because we sit in the computer, it does my boxing, and it takes fucking hours. But when you get folk coming on the show and telling us stories about how they listen to us when they're driving to their work, or people want to come on and say that they listen to us here, there, or anywhere, and we get told that we're number one in fucking Macedonia or whatever the fuck it is, it just really...
Cayman Islands.
It really just makes everything all worthwhile, and thank you for sticking by us all this year, and I couldn't have done it without any... three close pals that really mean a lot to me, and I know they've got my back and I've got them.
So thanks for all your nominees, and remember, you'll hear all the best bits of Football Daft from the year in the next couple of weeks.
Football Daft with G4 Claims. Been involved in a road traffic accident? Call them now on 01698 767 172.
Right, troops, the Christmas party is kicking off. The door has went. There's somebody at the door. Are we going to answer it? There's somebody at the door.
I'm excited. I don't know who's going on.
It's your plus one, Stevie. It's your plus one.
Is it my plus one? Who have I got again? Oh, aye, right. I know who I've got. It's wee Cammy. He was on Rangers Daft. He's going to be one of the biggest fucking wee heartthrobs in River City, I think.
Oh, is this Cameron the boy? I've seen this boy on Twitter.
Cammy, there he is. There he is. You're there, my man.
How you doing, lads? You alright? What a fucking thing to be alive, eh? Sitting there in park, me.
Check him out, man. Pretty green hat, his t-shirt, Daniel Radcliffe's face.
Mate, I just introduced you as River City's newest fucking heartthrob, man, and you've no let me down, man. You're a handsome boy tonight, mate. Looking good,
mate. No, chivalry's going to beat any bad feeling that I've got, man. You're not going to make me feel any better. Stop trying.
Chris, your plus one's at the door now.
My plus one?
Ah, your plus one.
Ladies
it's a Christmas party.
Welcome. The strongest man in Scottish football. The Falkirk manager, Mr. David McCracken.
What's happening, team?
Hello there!
There he is.
Lads, we could have picked our guests better. They're making us look like fucking ugly bastards.
I know, man.
Right, I know. Here, Cracks, how you doing? And I really want to know this. What was the Rangers like at Falkirk a couple of weeks ago, man? Tell me what they were like.
What were the Rangers like?
Aye.
Doesn't he know he watched the whole game like that?
Bang average, to be honest. Nah, honestly, by the way, that's the best they've been for a long, long time. Aye. Don't get me wrong, we set up right to try and stoke some of the stuff that they do. We still couldn't do it.
You know what I mean?
I thought you played all right, Cracks. I thought you played well, mate.
I thought you played well, Cracks. Fuck off, you get hammered.
Hey, you. Oh, Paul, Crystal, this is the Falkirk manager's on. Thanks very much.
Yeah, man, get me somebody else on. I'm well outnumbered here.
Paul, you're saying they get hammered, man. They done me a McGoo's done. They got a couple of shots on target, man.
That's true. They didn't do as well as St. Mum, did they? Right, anyway.
Fucking fuck!
Only about a time before that came in, wasn't it?
Cracks, do you watch River City? Because we've got the new star in our Christmas party.
I have watched it before, but I've not been watching it recently, now. I've just moved into a new place, so I've not got a telly yet. My Sky and all that's fucking done, and it's not even set up yet.
You hit the Sky player on your phone, mate. Don't geez it.
Hey, lads, it's a Christmas party, innit? I think we better play some music.
No.
Oh, that's pathetic, man. That's a redneck.
Could you not just sing it yourself, Fergus? You'll have heard that a lot over the last 3 months, you know.
Sorry, what was that again? I know the fucking words. Front to back now.
I'm just glad there was no sharks at Ibrox last night outside the stadium and all that, and there was no security gates up and all that after a defeat. So,
aye, near accident, Mark.
Did you see the guy that built Celtic Park out his back garden for his wee boy?
I've seen that, by the way.
Somebody's took fencing and put it outside his gate.
It's amazing.
Brilliant, isn't it?
That is a cracker.
Let's not fall out. What's everybody doing at Christmas?
Aye.
I'm meeting up with two different households. What about you guys?
Well, I'm working. No,
he's got boxing getting, game.
He's all be getting fucking pushed up. I'll be working, man.
Cracks, listen, you get mentioned on this show every single week, mate.
Every week, Cracks. Every week.
Because I'm mutter.
Scoring the quiz, right? I know. I'm going to blindside you with this one, Cracks. We're going to give you another quiz today, my man. How do you feel about that?
Honestly. Is the show that bad now? You haven't even fucking bring me on to get any answers again.
When are we doing that?
I'll have you know we're the number one podcast in the Cayman Islands, you prick.
True story, mate. Number one in the Cayman Islands. No joke. John, tell him.
Trying to understand the fucking the boys' language, though, right?
No, they probably just look at the video and just point at me and laugh.
It's the fucking size of a millport. I've just looked at it and now it's obviously somebody that works here that maybe listens to this now and again, and it's just fucked up all the ratings. That's what that is.
I'm not wanting the realistic outlook on this and the probability that is the truth. I want to have the fantasy that there's hundreds of wee guys that's down the Cayman Islands have got Football Daft t-shirts and all that, and they walk about and they love this show.
They all go into their mates house and all that and watch your podcast.
Aye. And they go out about me and Toe. Look at the two midgets. I don't know one word they're saying between them, man.
Look how tight.
And they all fancy John.
They fancy old John.
John will be wanting to do Football Daft in the Cayman Islands next year.
Aye, he is, man. He's got to get the road show going.
Absolutely. We'll get Cracks. We've got Cracks on. We'll give him the quiz because we want to get Cracks off the bottom because I can't have the Falkirk manager at the bottom of the leaderboard.
He's a front it for you, Cracks.
He's every week, man.
Honestly, don't worry about it. I came to terms with years ago that I'm sick as shit, so don't worry about it.
First question is, how do you spell your first name?
Is that what one's my first name again?
Right, let's get the party started then. Are we ready to do the quiz?
Aye, let's do it. Come on, that's good.
John, do you want to read the questions? Because you are Falkirk through and through. You read the questions to your
manager.
I can go
time.
Right, I mean, okay. If you you
honestly, man, I put my heating up too high. I'm absolutely sweating here.
I am the same. I'm sweating.
Don't worry. If it gets near the end to cracks, I'll make sure they're dead easy. We're going to get you off the bottom of this. You've got to get three pretty much to get to equal the second bottom, all right? So,
where did I get it last time? One.
You got one.
One.
You got one. Right, okay. So, that's basically, you know how it works. We've got 90 seconds on the clock. Top of the leaderboard with 15. It's been a while since you've been on, Crack, so we're up to 15 now. John Sutton and Chick Young are joint top with 15. Mark Wilson, Keith Lasley are top behind on 14. Kenny Duker, Kevin Harper on 13. Lee obviously scored 6 when he was on, so that's what you've got to aim for, so you can walk into training tomorrow and get it up him. Marco Negri's on 5, and Craig Levine is on 3. You need to aim for 3 here, Cracks.
Marco Negri?
Marco Negri, bye. He's a
fucking... Do you know what, Cracks? Cracks, Marco Negri couldn't even understand what we were saying. They still got 5.
He even got the fucking Stenhouse Muir question right there.
He did, aye. He did.
He just kept answering every question, went, at the end of it, didn't he?
we need to target 3, and you need to get 6 to either level or beat Lee, Crack. Right. So,
if I don't know it, then you need to answer it, right?
No.
I tell you what, right, wait a minute. What if Cameron gets the answer if you don't know it?
Oh, fuck, here we go, man.
Oh, no, that'll be an asterisk on it. I don't want David.
Aye, we don't do asterisks, though.
Exactly.
I'll just be at the bottom of the league. It doesn't matter if there's an asterisk
or not. All right, Cracks, you can just liquidate yourself and come back
to somebody else anyway. Fuck it. So, Cracks, you can't pass. You must give an answer. Is there 90 seconds on the clock, Grado?
90 seconds, start.
No answers like the last time.
Right, what team are currently bottom of the Scottish Premiership?
Hamilton.
Peter Grant is the manager of what team?
Alwa.
Cluj FC play in which country?
Belgium.
Who currently wears the number 18 jersey at Falkirk?
Oh, shit. Connor Salmon.
Diego Axel of Celtic is on loan from which club?
I've no idea what he said, so I'll just say Bayern Munich.
Name one of the joint top scorers in the English Premier League.
Who's the joint top scorers?
Yeah, one of them. One of them. Let's see.
One of them. Dennis Bergkamp. Fuck knows.
What team play their games at the C&G Systems Stadium?
Oh, wow.
They're in our league, Cracks. They're in our league.
I know that, so I know it.
We Fulham River City out there.
Give us an answer.
You wouldn't take your daughters to their ground.
Give us an answer. Just give us an answer.
I don't know. You've lost me now. Dumbarton.
Yes. Dumbarton.
And what year were Falkirk formed?
Oh, shit.
Look at the threat in John's voice. Come on, fucking...
Hurry up, man.
1867.
What two teams compete in the Renfrewshire Derby?
The Renfrewshire Derby. Paisley. The
Renfrewshire
Derby.
Time!
Oh!
But he's got it. He gets the answer. He gets
answer
the answer.
That one.
What was the question again? Renfrewshire Derby?
Two teams compete in the Renfrewshire Derby.
The Renfrewshire Derby? Fuck knows. I don't know. Are we talking professional teams here?
Aye.
That's right, St. Mirren. St. Mirren.
St. Mirren and...
Watch Renfrewshire.
Derby.
Derby? No, that's mine, me. St. Mirren and Morton?
Yes!
Yes! Yes! Oh, amazing. Morton's no in fucking Renfrewshire, is it?
No, but Greenock is.
Right, we'll go through the questions. We'll give you the wrong answers, Cracks. Ross County are currently bottom of the Premiership. Cluj playing Romania. Diego Axel is on loan from AC Milan. You could have had Calvert-Lewin, Songkun Min or Salah for the top scorer.
That? That
but he went for Bergkamp.
Falkirk, for fuck's sake, you're clearly not a badge kisser, Cracks. 1876, Falkirk.
That's what it says, isn't it?
The Morton.
Well, you say the 1867.
No, never. Always invented. No, never.
And it's Morton. Morton is playing the Renfrewshire Derby. However, after that struggle, you've got 4 points and you're off the bottom of the leaderboard.
Yeah, beauty.
So who's get bottom now then? Is it Craig Levein?
Craig Levein.
Craig Levine's bottom now. Oh,
even better, by the way. Let me go at Dundee United.
And Grado, that's your plus one just arrived for the party.
Please introduce him just now. Please welcome to Football Daft. He is none other than the man who was behind this podcast, who went behind a lot of people's backs. We can maybe even discuss this on the show, actually. That'd be pretty good.
You and Cameron.
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Let's see your face,
we need to explain something that we've never spoken
about. Oh, hold on a minute. Right. Jeez, right. I'm here. There I am. Hiya.
Wait, have you been busy tonight, mate?
Eh?
What have you been up to tonight?
Oh,
what
are your hearts?
He's got his heart. Yeah. Badges.
Ewan, it's the year 2020 and you're still walking about with that chain on, man. What are you doing? What's that?
Can I just say, this show sounds like a shambles. I don't know who's speaking. I don't know what you're asking me. I don't know why I'm here. Clearly somebody pulled out and I've been dragged in at the last second. Oh. And I've just realised David McCracken's here. Who's the boy with the Adidas top on?
How you doing, Cammy?
I'm joking. I can see it's Cameron. David McCracken, are you in a fucking jail cell?
Aye. Hey, it was better than that fucking strippers joint you're in. That would be that red lighting, by the way.
You're in Cameron coming straight.
Wait. I'll just explain for anyone who might be listening to this. Not that there's that many. There was more when I was on, but for those who are listening. Hold on a second.
You were the number just one in the Cayman Islands, you fucking arsehole.
Hold on a wee second. I have, this is what's called mood lighting in the bedroom. I'm going to just change the colours. There you go.
There we go. Is that so your missus doesn't see you coming?
Anyway, what am I on for anyway?
Just think of a wee blather.
We just wanted to say Merry Christmas,
mate. It's a wee Christmas party. And Grado's pals pulled out, man, so he just phoned you.
Toll.
Yes, mate.
St Mirren made your season last night, did they?
Fuck's sake.
Do you know what? It's Christmas, you, and we'll not go down that road. How's Hearts getting on?
Don't go there, mate.
What do you think that result will do for Rangers last night? What do you honestly think? Because you've texted us, me and Bob, before and said Rangers are going to win the league. What do you think now after last night? Do you think that wee jitter has done it?
I tell you what, if you don't go to Dubai, the league is yours.
He's been saying Rangers are going to win the league for the last fucking 10 years.
So he has.
I'll tell you what, you might win the league, but you'll not do another treble.
The best was when he got asked to do the super scoreboard on Clyde, man, and it was with Hugh Keevans, and he pissed off Hugh Keevans. It was the best, wasn't it? Rangers are going to win the league. I'm not having it. Rangers are going to win the league. And he could tell he was getting fucking grumpy.
Yeah, but do you know what the biggest mistake I made doing that show? It was about a month before the season started, and I went on to cover it. And then once I started saying that, I couldn't stop myself. I was like, Neil Lennon is getting sacked before Christmas. First year in the job. Right, he's getting sacked before Christmas, and then it made all the bloody papers. And Ewan said this about Neil Lennon, and said that about Neil Lennon. And then when Lennon went and won the treble,
it went viral.
But once Celtic won the treble, Toll was one of the first people to remind everybody of what I said a year earlier.
Listen, guys.
So what? Why are you here, David McCracken?
Oh, just for the banter, just because I'm trying to get quiz questions.
He was bottom of the quiz. We've had a quiz all season, and David McCracken, since he came on, like, after you done the bunk, Ewan, one of the second guests we had on was McCracken and Lee Miller. David McCracken scored one in a 90-second quiz, and he's been at the foot of the table for nearly the full year. But he just came on there, done the quiz, and he got four, didn't he?
Just battered it, It should have been seven, but we'll take four.
Should have been seven.
It's true what they say about footballers then.
What? They'll kick fuck out you if they slag them.
Right.
That, yeah. But there isn't a brain, but they've not got two brain cells to rub together.
Listen, you don't need brain cells when you've got fucking money, mate.
Yeah. Who cares about being a fucking general knowledge quizmaster? I'm not giving a shit.
Ewan, what I want to know is, will there be any plans to bring back the Late Show in STV2? That's what I want to know.
Mate, what I mean, really? We've all been part of something in our life that hasn't worked out as well as you think it would work out, right?
No, Ewan, I can vouch for Grado here. Grado, actually, we spoke about this quite a lot during Parental and stuff. He's being sincere here because he did like that show. He's not taking the piss, mate.
Thanks for the support, lads. I'm now waiting for the punchline.
There's no punchline.
Hey, but Cammy, not as much as I like River City, my man.
Listen, mate, that's all purdy, man. I've just been in there 5 minutes. Don't you worry about it.
But you're enjoying it, Cameron.
They've brought you in so that they can ease him out the door. You're the new young.
Aye, man. Watch Bob's face here, man.
Money, man, he's going to be going that slippery slope down into Shield Inch fucking river.
Slippery slope.
Slippery slope.
Man, start reading up like Auto Trader and getting good at mechanics and all that. I don't know what that's.
Are you enjoying it, Cameron?
It's brilliant, mate. I love it, man. It's a great group of people. Obviously, just with the circumstances, and we're hardly seeing each other, so you don't feel like you're working as obviously a part of a team as you were before. But it's brilliant, man. Just hoping that obviously we get to all get together as soon as we possibly can in a safe environment. Well, but
To sit in the canteen together, man. Just sit around the big table and have a blether. Do you know what I mean?
Hopefully you last longer than me, mate.
Grado, where were you then in River City? I can't remember that.
Arrested. Right. Had to look myself in a fucking room, man, and just try and find the character. Know what I mean?
It was like Robert Downey Jr. in Tropic Thunder.
but here's the thing about Grado stepping up to play to be an actor in River City. He was actually to turn up as himself in a job that he knew really well, and he still fucked it up. He couldn't even play himself. He couldn't even play himself. And he was kicked out after 8 episodes.
I heard the rumour some of the producers were sitting on a table going, after his 8 episodes, going, this guy doesn't know how to play a wrestler, man. He doesn't know.
This guy's shite at wrestling.
The guy phoned me and went, do you want to be in River City? And I went, if you want. I goes, I've never
the done guy phoned me.
He did. I remember it. I was in a hotel in London. I was wrestling in London. He says, do you want to be in River City? I says, right. He says, I goes, but I've never fucking done acting. I goes, I played Jeremy Clarkson, kid when I was in Tokyo in Primary 7. I think that's about the best of it. He says, I'll be fine once you get in the set. We'll struggle to keep the camera off you. I went, like, right, cool. And that was it. That's fucking. And then he says, what name do you want to be? And that was the best. I remember sitting down and going, fucking hundreds of names. I had Sandy, Dusty, Buster. Obviously, I went for Buster. But I got to pick my name. I think that was cool. Because you couldn't use Gradle. But it was cool.
And what was the reason that they got rid of you?
Well, there's a couple of reasons. I mean, I fucking slagged them in the paper by accident. And I don't think that went down too well, didn't it? Well, because I remember and probably leaning a set full of 30 people to go and do a night shift in the fire brigade didn't help me matters either.
So I'm still kind of scratching my head as to why you're not there anymore.
But Grado, to give Grado some sort of credit, what was it again? There was something on ITV primetime at 9 o'clock.
Endeavour.
He was on Endeavour, right? So he messaged me, I'm on Endeavour. And I was doing Football Daft at the time. And he was going down for rehearsals and he was going down for... You never got the part. Did you have to go and do a rehearsal or something? I can't remember what it was.
I did get the part.
I know that, but when you kept going up and down to London, what do you call that again?
Auditions.
Aye. So he was going down to London to do the auditions and all that stuff, and then he got the part, and then he messaged me to say, right, it's on the night. And I genuinely thought I was going to watch this and just piss myself laughing.
It was Grado,
try to be an actor. And I tell you what, knowing Grado as well as we do, Stephen, that was BAFTA winning.
Scottish BAFTA winning.
But it was BAFTA winning.
What did you play in Endeavour, Grado?
I played a gay wrestler.
He played that.
You're range again.
So that's that.
All joke aside, he was, you were shit hot in that, but mate,
but
you
not,
were,
but he also played the part of an Englishman as well. What was the accent, Grado?
What was it again? What did I have to say again?
I'm Grado.
He got somewhere. He got somewhere. I remember that because I remember the guy. I mean, I'd never met this guy, and you know, I had to. He was in his 50s, and I had to basically stop him in the stairs and rub his chest and ask him if he had somewhere to go and bang. That's what I had to do. You got somewhere. Aye, it was Manchester accent.
Well, it was Manchester, was it?
Cracks, right, I'll ask like, you as well, Cracks, you and Ewan, right, who do you think will win the league this year, like Rangers or Celtic?
What do you mean, Falkirk? You mean you're talking
about the league in
here, aye.
John,
what's
happening
here? Is this like a Rangers and Celtic podcast?
You know what? I'm starting to worry, Danny. That's what I'm starting to worry.
Who's going to win the league? Fucking Falkirk.
Yeah, Falkirk,
I don't know, mate. It's between yous and Cove Rangers, man. I don't know. It's a tough one.
Falkirk will walk League One. Hearts will walk the Championship. Rangers will win the Premiership. Liverpool will win the English Premiership.
Yeah, we go.
I'd agree with all of that, but maybe no Hearts. I think Dunfermline will get a good bash.
Oh, shut up, Davey.
I'm being serious.
Shut up.
Being serious. Fucking
what have you seen Dunfermline's last couple of results?
Two results, that's what it is.
Mate, they've already blown. They're already, the wheels have fallen off them already. You're
mate, did you not just get beat off Fowler?
That's not the point.
Aye.
That's not the point.
Guys, there's somebody else at the door for the Christmas party. Chris has got another guest coming on.
Oh, yeah,
Marco Negri.
Is this my big strike partner?
Is there we go. Big handsome himself. Fucking the stories that this guy came out with when he was on the show earlier on in the year.
Who is it?
Big Brian McPhee.
It's Brian McPhee.
Who's Brian McPhee?
He played. He's an Airdrie legend, mate.
Mate, he's a fucking Scottish footballer. Are you not meant to know your stuff about football, Ewan?
What team did he play for fuck's sake?
Airdrie!
Played for Airdrie.
Airdrie!
What, the Airdrie of today or the old Airdrie that died?
Brian, are you taking this piss off of him?
Mate, I'll smash the cunt.
It's happening, my man. Thanks for coming back on.
No problem, buddy. Good to see you. I hope you're all well.
We're doing good.
Brian, wait a minute. Just to establish who he is, I want to know who the guy is. Can I ask a couple of questions? Well, Brian, what position did you play at Airdrie?
Pass. No, I played centre forward. I played a striker.
How many goals did you score? What was your best season?
I don't know, 17, 18. I played with Livingston as well for 4 years, and I played with Hamilton Accies for 4 years.
Ewan doesn't really know his football, but mate, do you know what I mean?
I mean, no disrespect, Brian, but Livingston, Hamilton, and Airdrie's not really my level. I talk more like.
It is Hearts level, mate. It is.
Are you still playing, Brian? Or
Brian, I'm going to give you his phone number. You can hunt this prick down.
No, I just turned 50 in October there, so no, I'm not playing at all now.
How good does he look for 50, man? How good does he look for 50?
Hey, me and Big Brian play up front together on the charity matches. The guy's built what a tank and can still move, man. Can still move.
Coffee and cream, mate. Coffee and cream.
Exactly, mate. That's what we are.
Cracks, did you ever come up against Brian on the pitch?
I don't think I did, no. I think I missed out on that, to be fair. I don't know.
David's playing at a higher level.
I hate keyboard gangsters, honestly.
Wait,
maybe at Livingston, Brian. I'm not sure.
First impression, is that?
By the way, I can't wait for the first football daft celebrity boxing event that we're putting on.
No, Ewan would never make the ring, man. He gets fucking bullied on the train, never mind getting a ring.
Aye, remember that? We'd tell that. Aye. Tell that story. Aye.
One night, right, he was staying Pantle with us, right, in Glasgow. And,
oh, no, sorry.
Well, to be fair, if you came and seen it, he wasn't he really? He was on stage, he wasn't he? He was trying to do Pantle. But anyway, that's a different story, man. But he was driving in the train the way home. We've got a group chat. He's texting us all. Guys, just let us know. I'm kind of, there's some guys on the train. They're throwing Maltesers at me. They're throwing Maltesers.
So, I think they're Hibs fans.
I think they're Hibs fans, and they're getting a wee bit aggressive now. So then that me and Gabe are laughing, and then it escalates again. Right, there's about six Maltesers hit my face now, and they're starting to shout things. I phoned my wife. She's getting me at the other end. She's getting me at the other end.
But at the time we were fucking...
His wife's coming in.
You were going, let us know when you get in, Ewan, mate. Let us know when you get in.
Like, he's too right. He's too right to throw you. You're not right, mate.
Ewan, what is the worst...
That's a packet of Maltesers. What the fuck's happening, man?
See, the worst thing is, the fucking picked him up and started eating him.
By the way, you've got a Vin Diesel look about you.
Vin Diesel, you reckon?
Aye, Brian looks a wee bit like Vin
Diesel.
Is that
Toll? Toll you talking about? Yeah.
Vin DeVito.
I'll take that. You're actually on. You're a good cunt, by the way. It's not true.
It's caused him his chance of a boxing match. He fucking shot himself, man. Stop
right
into
his
he's just revealed he's 50. He couldn't box his way with a wet paper bag.
Oh, Brian. Just get a packet of Maltesers, Brian. You'll be all right.
Cameron, by the way, can I just say this? And I don't know if you've had it before. Why don't you look a fair bit like James Forrest? See you in the face. Do you know you listen to Forrest? Have you had that before?
Me?
No, I've not had that, no. But I'm not going to stand against him in case he turns up at my door with a box of Maltesers and batters my cunt in.
Hates you on the train. Oh, man.
James Forrest, man.
So, which is everybody obviously already. You get everything in, everything sorted. Santa ready for coming down the chimney.
Is this what this has turned into?
Ewan, do you know what? See if you've no getting nice to say fuck off.
we're on here to talk about Christmas trees and decorations and what we're getting for Christmas.
It's a Christmas party, mate. What do you want to talk about? Fucking the championship.
Do you know what I want to ask before we wrap it? I want to ask, what's happening in the Scottish Cup final, Ewan? Are you confident?
Aye.
No. I'm not. Nah, I'm not.
How no?
Celtic have got Scotland. Wee bit more quality, haven't they? I mean, let's be honest about it. They have. And yeah, I know Celtic haven't been playing well recently. They've had some really awful results particularly against Ross County. That was our huge shock. But I just think that Celtic on the day, what they're going for is a quadruple, treble, Toll.
Aye.
I just don't see Hearts. I mean, I think it'll be a good game. I think it'll be tight. I think there may be a goal in it. But I just don't see Hearts.
Andy Halliday winner, Ewan. No fancy an Andy Halliday winner.
I think he's a waste of money. I've not been impressed with him.
You, what do you think about Stephen Kingsley?
Great. By the way, I'm shocked that they've only signed him for a year.
Yeah.
They've only got him on a year deal. They need to get him signed up sooner rather than later to a longer term deal because he's been outstanding for us.
Is that a party thistle mascot?
Ewan, what did you think of the Hearts documentary, man? I fucking loved
it. It was awful. Do you know why it was awful? Because what you do when you see something like that, oh, it's behind the scenes, and what you think straight away is like what they did with Spurs and what they done on Amazon Prime when they got access to Man City, they got access to Spurs and all that. I mean, that was proper access. It was well done. It was well made. It's just typical BBC Scotland. It's a bit like River City comparing it to EastEnders. Do you know what I mean? It's low budget.
You're just
still
a fucking
jam,
Andy, aren't you, man?
It's a bit like comparing an STV2 show because on at 11 o'clock at night to River City, do you know what I mean? It's not.
Well, I think that was a nibble there, Ewan.
We nibble. Brian, what team do you support?
Me, Rangers.
Yeah,
for fuck's sake, Ewan, I can't believe you're the, you're my only one that's not a Rangers fan.
Ewan is a Rangers fan.
I've been to Ibrox with Ewan.
Aye. Ewan's been at more Rangers games than Gradle.
Ewan's been at more Rangers games than Walter Smith.
Davey, what team do you support?
Falkirk, of course.
Yeah, right.
No, I was brought up a Celtic fan.
What are you, cracks?
All right, okay.
Aye.
There we go. Yes, I've got another.
And after recent protests, he's now a Falkirk man.
After he get caught flinging a shot,
I nearly
get
in jail for throwing a fence at somebody.
Cameron, what team do you support?
I'm a Rangers man, mate. Aye, season ticket holder at Ibrox.
Of course he is, man. I brought him on. That mean I bring a good looking boys on. That
So, John, what team do you support?
I don't think we need to go into that, do we?
Aye, John, Ewan is a Rangers man and John's a Celtic man, but they've got fucking kiddie on teams and all, do you know what I mean?
Aye.
You mean your AC Milan, Stevie?
Aye. Bit of respect to you, eh?
do you know one of the biggest mistakes I made a few mistakes when I worked on the football phone for those 10 years, but just talking about Celtic and Rangers and the kiddie on teams and all that stuff, and I used to out, like, media people just because I thought, if you're not going to be honest, then I'm just going to out you on the radio. So I used to out like journalists and media people and the real teams that they supported in that. And then one night we were doing the football phone in and I just admitted, I think it was Rangers were at the UEFA Cup final against Zenit St. Petersburg. And I was on that. I travelled with Rangers that entire trip for the UEFA Cup final. And it was a brilliant trip. I was sporting Lisbon that night when Whittaker does that run from halfway, and it was a brilliant night. You get caught up in it, you do. And I remember being on the radio and saying how I wished that I could be a Rangers fan just for this trip to the UEFA Cup, just to have that feeling in your stomach and in your... But for me to even admit that I would like to have been a Rangers fan for that night, it went down like a lead balloon. Do you know what I mean? As a Hearts fan, I'll never experience that feeling of my team going all the way to a final in Europe. Now, I enjoyed it, but you don't get the feeling like what Steven gets or like when Toll's team went to Seville and I was there for that as well. I won't ever have that feeling. So I just admitted on the radio I'd love to be a Rangers fan.
He might get to the Petrofac Cup final this season.
Anyway. That's what the one everybody's been fucking playing for.
You get one of them, Brian.
Two? We played there during the final. And we get beat penalties. So, no, get one of them. I've got a first division and a second division medal.
You cracks, you've got a new trophy in your cabinet, haven't you, my man?
Just another one. Aye.
There we go. another Manager of the Month award. That's fucking...
Did he actually get that? Aye.
Of course he did.
Manager of the Month and off the bottom of the leaderboard of the quiz. Hey. That's a good one.
Absolutely flying, by the way.
By the way, 2020 got off to a bad start, but it's turning up now, innit, my man?
I'm on a roll, getting into 21. Here we go. Come on.
Are you looking for a 50-year-old striker?
It's already got one, fucking
sorry, I've already got one. Aye, Lee's already in there.
Yeah, can I just see before we wrap things up, can I just ask Mr. Ewan Cameron one thing, mate? Where have you been on FIFA? What's been happening there?
I've got the PlayStation 5, so I've been playing on the new console.
Get a PlayStation 5 and all, mate. What do you make of the trigger buttons? They're fucking brutal, aren't they?
I love the trigger buttons. You've been playing Call of Duty?
No, what
fucking age you use, man?
Call of Duty?
So, Ewan, maybe when Santa brings me my PS5, maybe we could get a wee game of FIFA, because...
100%.
It's been a while since I've pumped you.
It has been a while, but let's not talk about that. Brian, do you play FIFA?
No, I don't. I play COD.
Oh, but I tell you what, Ewan, he's been in FIFA. Have you?
Brian's not been in FIFA.
Aye, he's fucking has.
No, he's not.
Aye, has when he was with Livy. Aye, has when he was with Livy or Hamill Mackie.
If Brian was in FIFA, let's assume for a second that Brian was in FIFA, he wouldn't be getting a face model of his face. It'd just be one of those regen faces.
No, no, no. see, fucking even without you slagging me about it, I was white in it.
You were white in it.
You're joking.
Fucking blood there, blue eyes.
Are you seriously, Brian?
I was in it, mate. I was in Sensible Soccer, that's
the father getting
back.
Sensible Soccer was class. Yeah, Tol, we're going to be in the next FIFA, remember?
I know, we had Derek Ray on the show and he's promised to get me and Stephen and Grado's names put into the commentary. Aye.
That's amazing, man.
You're just trying to make Grado, you're trying to make Grado feel better. Grado was half that week.
I know, but listen, I'm just wanting to wind up. Look at Ewan's face, he's fucking beeling.
I'm not amused, but me and Derek Ray don't get on, so that's a touchy subject.
I think you mentioned that to me once.
Anybody?
You mentioned that to me once, I remember that.
How did you know you?
Me and Derek Ray had a massive... do you remember, who's the other famous Aberdeen fan? Bald head, used to be in a band, worked
Jimmy Somerville?
No, not Jimmy Somerville.
He was in a band, didn't he?
No, he was in a boy band. He was in an Aberdeen fan.
Ali Begg.
I got on a huge thing with Ali Begg online. I don't know if John will remember this, but I got on a huge thing with Ali Begg. And then the papers picked up on it. And then it carried on for two more days. And then for some strange reason, Derek Ray got involved and started backing up Ali Begg. And then me and him went at it for a wee while. And then he blocked me.
That's it, Brian. Oh, yeah. He must have been following him for a while.
Before this kicks off, let's keep the Christmas spirit going and just wrap up now.
This is how all good Christmas parties end.
I dust up, man. The Gavin and Stacey Christmas special.
Brian, at his age, he needs to get to his bed, so come on, we should wrap this up.
Right, troops, cheers for coming on.
Thanks very much.
Have a good Christmas. Thanks,
Brian. Cheers.
Have a good Christmas, everybody. Right.
Cammy, I'll see you soon, buddy.
Brian.
Right.
On the
bends. On the bends.
Brian, are you on Facebook?
Yes.
I'll find you on Facebook and you can block me.
I look forward to it.
Football Daft with G4 Claims. Been involved in a road traffic accident? Get them now at notatfaultclaims.com.
Right, troops. Obviously, for me and Tolt's a bit different, right? Cato's been here before, done it with all Football Daft, but it's Christmas time, it's the end of the year. I just want to say, and I think Tolt feel the same. I've enjoyed this year. I've enjoyed being part of the Football Daft family. It's been great fun in a podcast with my two good mates and Tol. So I just want to kind of go like that.
Do you know, sometimes words hurt, Stephen.
You know I'm joking. But I'm only joking, mate. No, honestly, it's Christmas. It's been a great time and me and Tol, obviously, lucky to be part of this podcast.
Absolutely. I'd like to, obviously, echo that sentiment as well, but this came out of the blue for me, totally came out of the blue for me. I got a message from Grado saying you might be part of Football Daft, and I thought it was just a one-time thing. And do you know something? The amount of people that have stopped me in the street and stuff like that to talk about it has been tremendous. I've had folk coming in, workies, that are absolute avid listeners to the show. And it really does open your eyes to how popular the show is, and it's a great honour to be a part of it. And it's great to be a part of it with you guys as well.
Aww.
You want to tell that big bastard in it all?
Nah, mate, it takes about 4 weeks.
We'll save it till 2021, man. We need something okay. To not we? Right. All the best.
Lads.
Right.
Yes.
Right. Chatting then.
God bless
you. See you later. Have a great Christmas, Paul.
God bless you, Paul.
See you soon, mate. Right. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow morning. Audio Frontier.